kan selalu hilang kat situ. Try to, I don't know, introduction is very, very important. So, usually student will say, today I would like to present, wah boringnya. You can ask a question. You can say, berbalas pantun. Tapi janganlah buang masa. Yeah. So, the content of your presentation, whether you have enough information and example, organized systematically, accurately, relevantly, completely. So you will have intro, background, problem statement, objective. We will show you. We'll give you the template later on. So kalau dia systematically, and then you can present systematically lah within the group member. Then you are in between 9 to 10. Target kat sini lah. Okay? Defense ability. The panel will ask you question. Dr. Nahani, bukan jarang-jarang soalan ni, Anil. Soalan Dr. Nahani.
Mengak-mengak.
Kasih dia, group amat. Dr. Nahani akan tanya soalan. Apa dia tanya, Anil ni?
Saya tanya ke orang ekonomi. So, salah.
Okeylah. Saya pun, sweet je soalan saya. Baik gila. Data tak betul, habislah. So, but defensibility is how you are able to answer. But if you know it's wrong, jangan berkelahi lah. If you know your data is, sorry, we did not note that, but thank you for your feedback. We will improve this in our report. Cakap lah macam ni, jangan. I'm sure I'm right, blah blah blah. Janganlah bergaduh dengan panel. Fluency clarity, so this is the part where you need to practice. So next week, that's why we can't have it next week. I don't want you to cincai duit lah. You need to practice within the group member. Have your script. Kalau nak baca sekarang, I tak nampak because of the online. But even if you want to read, please don't read. Macam read. Macam mana nak cakap eh? Don't read the slides. You talk to us, yeah. You talk to us. You present to us. Audio visual make it as inspiring as possible. Lots of diagram is possible. Not too much writing. The rule of thumb is kalau boleh not more than 20 words. That's what they say in a slide. Not more than 20 words. Not too much wording. Non-verbal communication. All right. Look at the camera. Yeah. Look at the camera. Because yang tengok ada markah 9 to 10. Eye contact, gestures, your hand and what you wear. Yeah? Rugi kalau tak dapat markah full kat sini. Yeah? Kalau tak tahu macam non-verbal, you look at berita RTM TV1. You tengok orang yang pakai apa nama ya? Sign language tu. Wow. Dia punya face expression, it's full kan when they explain something. I like to see their sign language and then their facial expression. It's so expressive lah. Huh? Okay. And then time management, you need to practice also. Not more than 20 minutes, I think. 15. Berapa tak ni? 15 kan 20 minutes ni? Masih present lah.
Depend. Ya, depend dengan lain masa ya. Tapi kita selalunya boleh mostly 20 minutes lah untuk student prepare and Q&A dengan lecturer je lah. 20 minutes. Yeah.
Okay, give it about 15 minutes, alright? So, one person take about 5 minutes. So, you don't have too many slides, too much wording. 5 minutes each, about 15 minutes. And then question and answer. Plus minus technical. So, aim for 9 to 10. That's that one. Untuk report, untuk next time lain sikit. Next time tu, don't worry lah. Next time senang gila lah. Right. Let me show you the final presentation. Amar dah buat soalan? Dah letak soalan dah? Untuk ni, KET. Oh, apa soalan? Oh, bukan dia CA kah?
Dah.
Apa dah?
Refer dengan Nazirul.
Nazirul? Who is Nazirul? Let me ask the
Hello, madam. I'm here.
Gago, aku fikir Encik Nazirul ni. Oh. Let me ask the KPP lah. Kelak you nanya dengan...
Okay. So, yang ET kah?
Sudah. Oh, I nanya yang KPP lah.
Tracy pada KPP yang inform.
Ah.
Hmm. So, silaulah. Yang kau untukkan KPP dah bertukar. So...
Dah lah.
Madam Zahan yang selalu inform sudah.
Apa ada message dengan Dr. Margaret, I'll see what her answer.
Ya, yeah, new KPP ya.
Oh, okay, right. Soalan sudah ditanya, dah bagi. I want to give you an example of the oral presentation. Why I'm preparing for a presentation is because with this presentation, that's where you're going to improve your final report. Your introduction is here. I know there's quite a lot of wording, but restrict your wordings lah. So your background and your, can you see the slides, guys? Guys? Boleh ya? Okay. Ini memang saya punya PhD presentation. Why I'm showing it to you is PhD ke master ke sama je. 10 minit, 15 minit presentation. Seriously. And then the contents are also the same. So it's where they want to see how you talk, not really how you read. So do not read. See, I have the background and the problem statement in one slide. So I was talking about what my, where my area of data collection will be and what is the problem in the research study. The literature review buat macam ni, kotak je. Madam Ernie pun boleh show dia punya proposal, tapi because dia belum siap lagi master dia, I takut ada orang lain ambil idea kan. Oh, jangan dulu ni. Sebab selagi kita belum siapkan master or PhD, other people can kidnap your idea and buat paper habis lah. Yeah? So literature review, just the authors and the theme. One slide on that. Okay. What these people say, you can even divide into theories. The theories and the empirical evidence, if you remember. So you've got to tell us what they say and what it means. No point and you copy paste semua kat sini and then read to us. Memang aku tolak maka habis lah. Tak suka orang baca. Yeah? That means you are not ready. You do not know what the theory is. And then this is the evidence, empirical evidence. What did they say? These people said this. These people said that. So, then I pergi kepada objective hypothesis, also combined into one table. You do not have to read everything. Sebab objective sama, to determine if blah, 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 blah. And then the hypothesis is to answer the objective. And what are the analysis that in, that needs to be done to answer the objective and the hypothesis? Any questions so far? Am I talking to myself?
No, madam.
No question, madam.
Clear?
No
question,
madam.
So, whatever you write in chapter 3 is here though. Descriptive, t-test, correlation, regression, which today hopefully we can do. Right? So, madam Ernie dah explain to you a bit about descriptive. So, itu to answer all the objectives semua lah. Yeah? And then, theoretical framework. Tapi you kena cite where do you get the framework from. Ini I punya. So sebab tu I tak cite. I repeat, do not forget to cite where the framework is from. From your paper, you kena cite. Okay? And then your data. This is the final data. So you have to say from what year to what year. I tak letak sini sebab I mungkin... few of my slides I buang. You kena letak mana where your data is from, what year to what year, and the actual data that you've collected. Okay, data one slide, map of methodology one slide. You're going to do this. Let's do result. See, it's very simple je. Now result. This is the correlation. You kena ada satu on the descriptive. Descriptive satu on correlation and satu on regression. Ini t-test. I repeat. Result one is on descriptive, one on correlation, and one on regression. So result of the tiga. Okay. So tunjuk table macam ni. And then you explain. Lepas tu summary of findings. Refer back to your objectives. And then based on the finding, what do you find out? Okay. Contribution kalau ada. Tu je. Limitation. Habis. Okay. So today we're going to find out how to do correlation and then the regression. A little bit on descriptive lah. I nak you explain macam mana nanti. Ask me any question please. If you have any queries. Set dah. How far have you guys gone to? Pelik soalan. Sejauh manakah anda telah menyiapkan kerja anda? Cepat jawab. Katrina, how far? Katrina.
Kami orang collect data, Madam.
Masih collect data? Ya Allah, bila nak masakkan?
Dah habis collect dah. Mock stack dalam overview lagi.
Overview.
Madam, masak yang dalam e-views ke?
Bukan overview.
Yes. Masak dalam e-views. Betul. Dah masak dah lah?
Belum masak ni.
Dah goreng bawang belum? Goreng bawang is the descriptive part.
Pisau hilang.
Hah? Dah belum?
Tinggal nak masuk e-views.
Belum masuk e-views? Ya Allah, ya Tuhan. Sekejap lah. Bapak lagi. Alright. Okay, let me see one of your descriptive please. Let me see. Siapa yang ada? I nak komen. Descriptive before you proceed to correlation.
I recommend Fatin. Fatin dah collect lah.
Oh, good girl. Fatin?
Fatin nak jual.
Ya, kita ada duduk Fatin. Fatin memang best. Anak I nama Fatin juga. Sayang Fatin. Oh.
Fatin nak jual. Fatin nak jual.
Fatin nak jual. Are you here?
Yes, madam.
Okay. Suruh Nya je. Nya okey. Nya duduk setakat tu. Nya dah kumpul dah.
Oh, okay Fatin. Let me see. The descriptive. Just show me what you have.
Lambat madam. Laptop kami.
Oh, your group member?
Jap.
FC pun yang dah settle untuk conventional bank area pun boleh juga. Siapa area si ingat? Chelsea kah? Laura kah?
Not bank ya madam. Only one part yang we haven't collect which is...
Awak kah? Gupa awak kah?
Saya...
Yang present area?
Si.
Bukan. Saya cakap yang present area. Yang dah settle part yang untuk descriptive analysis. Maybe you guys can share a little bit what you have untuk Dr. Aziz teruskan dengan correlation.
I want to see the descriptive because before you proceed to correlation, there are a few things that you need to
consider,
address, yeah, to answer, to address, to make sure your data is okay. Descriptive ni ala-ala macam bila kita potong bawang nak, kita make sure bawang yang dah dipotong, siap dah buruk. That's why we check lah. And then kita nak make sure data you okay. Ramak je Fatin.
Sekejap benda lah.
Okay.
Jessica Robin kan? Fatin. Okey lah. Fatin lah. Alright.
Sekejap minta maaf. Tak matter.
Alright, okay. Fatinia, what's your title again?
Principal conflict during COVID-19 public listed company.
Oh, okay, okay. The one that I asked you specifically. Yeah. Okay. What I'm gonna look at is when you copy later on, you're gonna copy into 3 decimal point. Now, Fatina, make sure. So, you can copy semua. Tapi DPR, you save in another one. Save another tab. Right click descriptive. Right click. Semua. Pergi descriptive analysis bawah. Bukan.
You duplicate sheet.
Right click. Betul. Pergi. Click descriptive analysis. Right click. Move for copy. Jangan dulu. Move for copy. Create a copy. Create a copy. Tiba-tiba. Okay. Move to end. Never mind. Alright. Okay. Now in that tab, you akan edit lah. Yang tadi tu original. Yang kacau.
Okay, Madam.
Banner ni dah bagi tahu lah. Data descriptive, not your log one lah. All.
10 kali ulang.
Raw data. Betul lah? Raw data. Okay. Can you put this in 3 decimal point log? Semua. Select semua. Okay, 3 decimal point.
Cepat.
Okay, daripada atas lah, DPR, market cap, that's it. Click.
Cepat juga.
Siapa tau?
Sepatutnya apa? Tukarkan kepada number dulu.
Oh, tukar number lah.
Dah, Madam.
Sialah, fine.
Dah.
Okay. Contoh DPR, let's go through DPR. Now, DPR is dividend payout ratio, right? Okay. Is that in RM?
Yeah, no, okay. Percent.
Are you sure?
Yeah, ratio.
Percentage?
Uh-uh.
Okay, you put in the bracket, percentage. You have to write it down, yeah. Yang lain take note lah. Percentage, yeah. Percentage, dividend payout ratio. Okay. So that's 17%. Median is 0. It cannot be 0 now.
This one yang dah di lock now.
Eh, takut tak lock tu lah. Ada 0.
This one dah di lock or what, Fatin?
Lock apa Madam?
Tadi lock.
Jangan.
Raw data you set dah ke?
Raw data.
Ada tak?
Okay. Nak 743.
Bukan tak darling. Not this one. The descriptive.
Apa?
This one yang ori data ataupun you dah lock yang untuk DPR. Kalau yang lock besar gilanya pun. Two.
Belum lock tak nak?
Dah lock belum?
Belum tu. Market cap tu pun raw data. Ni ada two data guys. One is the raw data. Raw data is the one you collect. Yang 743. Tunjuklah Fatin. Okay. Yep, click. Now, these are all raw data, correct? Raw data means what you've collected, right? Terus it Fatin.
Ya betul.
Okay. Now DPR is percentage. Isikan percentage. 88 ringgit. 88%. Bankrupt lah 7-Eleven.
RM lah Madam.
Sen kot. Pun RM. 88 ringgit sikit unit. Dividend payout ratio. Are you sure? Cek balik lah apa ya?
Dividend payout ratio, Madam.
Cannot. Then 17 ringgit apa ya? Per unit. Cepat. Bankrupt company.
Okay, Madam.
This is how we ask you question during your presentation. We will go to your descriptive. We're going to ask you first. What is this? Is this RM or percentage? If your descriptive, listen guys, if your descriptive is wrong, then correlation regression confirm salah. Faham sih? Bawang you dah potong, ada buruk. Bila check ayam, ayam bulu-bulu belum buang. This is where we check lah. We can identify whether your data can go proceed to correlation regression. Right now, I'm asking Fatin, now dividend payout ratio, is it in RM or SEN? Cepat cek balik, 743 ya Fatin, go back. Dividend payout ratio selalunya, tekan 743, okay, payout. Aisyah, stop chatting. Sama kita off stop. Fatin, what's your group mate?
Dah, madam.
Mana group mate you senyap?
Line problem kali ni.
Okay, madam.
Can you double check whether this is in percentage or sen? You guys check, I want to ask market cap pula, correct? Okay, your group mate tolong check ya, DPR tu apa? Right, Fatin, go to market cap. Go to descriptive analysis tu, number 2. That one is raw data. I know because, can you put comma there? Market cap tu.
Comma.
DPR belum settle lah. Market cap semua RM is it? RM.
RM.
And million ke apa tu? Oh, billion. Can you please double check? Is it in million or billion?
Million sampai asal minum.
Nak tahu? Okay, go to 743. Go back to your first sheet. Tak semua million lah. Kosong-kosong-kosong lah ni. Semua kosong-kosong dah ni. Million dah ni.
30.
30 tu. You have to make sure 3 zeros.
Okay.
RM million tu. So the market cap is actually 1 billion ke apa ke? RM million.
0000.
Okay. Right. Okay, can you please put comma there? All the data from market cap. Put comma.
Comma.
Oh. Comma, comma di atas.
You click on C.
Click C.
Okay, click C. You got the ABR, okay? And then you go to general, ada yang number tu. Dekat tab atas. Yang general, dollar, percentage, and then you have comma.
Comma, comma.
Not the link. Just number. Alright. Number. Alright. Okay, you ada tengok koma sebelah percentage tu.
Okay.
Yeah, you click it.
Okay.
Click.
Slow lah nak ambil menu.
Yes.
Ya Allah, hampus nyawa aku nunggu.
Okay, 1,391,94.
Oh, 1 billion lah. 1 billion. You see, there's why this is important. I'm going to ask you, if the market cap is million, then it's quite small for a company, public sector company. Selalunya dalam 100 over 700, 300, 300, 400 million or billion. So here, on average, mean is the average value. Guys, listen, this is what you're going to present. On average, the market cap for the companies. So, dalam industri apa tak, Fatin? Semua kah?
Semua.
Oh, very good. For how many years?
1 year only.
1 year or cross-section or? Alright. So, how many company do you know?
743.
743. 740 lah. Actually, there are 1,000 plus, so you have to write down how many yang dikira lah, except for financial, utilities semua lah. Okay. So on average, the market cap is share price times share of public listed company in Malaysia for 2020 is 1.39 billion ringgit Malaysia. I repeat, on average, the market cap of public listed companies in Malaysia in 2020 is 1.39 billion. You faham sih?
Okay.
You have to understand what it means. Faham sih, Fatin? Your group. Fitra, semua? Mm-hmm. Alright. Okay, the median is, sebab tu dalam chapter 3, you have to write down what min means, what median means, what maximum minimum means. Sebab in chapter 4, you are going to explain one by one of the variable. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you have 5 variable, so at least 5 paragraphs telling about the company there. Macam tadi, on average, the company's market cap in Bursa Malaysia is 1.39 billion, where the maximum company has the highest market cap is at 71 billion. 71 billion dot maximum company. Now, take note, Fatin, find out which company. Pergi ke 743. Ingat 71 lah. Pergi 743. Okay, cari company mana yang 71 billion. You can search. Pergi ke find. Find. Nana, on your atas ya.
Atas.
Siapa?
Top
glove. Top glove. Oh, okay. Oh, sebab dynamic tak ada. I baru beli 5% bagi tip. Nanti aku. Top glove, 71 billion. Yes. In 2020, it is the biggest company. Why? Share price yang naik mendadak tahun 2020. Good. Okay. When you write in your paragraph later on, Fatin and your group, first you talk about the average market cap and the biggest company in Malaysia during 2020 is? Apa?
7 billion.
71 billion. Basil, apa kata Basil tak? Oh, tapi rugi saya beli. EY dah mau ah. I tanya my friend auditor dekat Sarawak. Dia kata company tu memang, dia orang target 20 sen tau. Tapi susah nak tu 20 sen. And then I'm just worried over the company whether they're going to be the next one MBB auditor, my friend yang mana? Shareholders tu kawan dia, they are honest people. So, I tak tahulah. I beli sikit je tadi, about 500 unit je. Right, back to Fatin. Okay, Fatin? Now, let's look at the smallest company in Bursa Malaysia. Go back to descriptive. Apa smallest company dekat? Eh, nama jawab pun. Klik.
Sampai pun
Mouse Takong. Allah. Do you want me to present?
Boleh lah, madam.
Okay, you share personal lah. Jangan share dalam group. Nanti semua curi you pun company.
Okay, madam.
Okay, you keluar je. You share personal.
Okay.
Tak boleh. Okay, Dr. Margaret dah jawab. Ama, I balas dalam MGT ya. Oh, biasalah. Orang baru kan. Okay, thank you. Right. I minta permission share, Fatina. New data. You message dia sendiri, Ma? Oh. You nak tanya apa? You ada nombor dia? Okay lah. Okay, you can leave. Fatin, let me show what you have. Huh? New data, okay. Alright, this, can you guys see? Guys, nampakkah?
Nampak.
Alright, thank you Fatin. Okay, these are your data. I can see a lot of NA here, but when you do your masters, you make sure you find out what are the data lah annual report. Untuk degree tak apalah. Kita tak suka yang NNA. Now kosong ni lain dengan NA ya. Kosong means kosong.
Excuse me.
Yes, yes.
Your slide.
Oh, sorry. I'm not showing, is it?
Yes.
Oh, thanks. Alright. Can you see now? Can you see now?
Yes, can madam.
Alright. I repeat ya. For your masters, your research nanti, you make sure data you ada NNA ni find out from the report. Because we don't like it when there's NA. Nanti dia tak hilang data lu ya. Data you ada banyak ni. Good job ya, your group. You have banyak about 744. Tapi bila ada NA, dia akan exclude. So jadi kurang. And then you make sure certain, macam zero ni, Centauria. Centauria ni problematic, betul lah. I beli apartment tu. Tak jadi. Kosong lho. Dia kosong. Macam tu lah, kosong tu lah. This kosong means takkanlah dia punya TA kosong. Macam tu. Guys, are you with me?
Yes.
Bila data kosong macam tu, check betul-betul. Memang kosong ataupun not available. Why? Because in your descriptive analysis, ni akan minimum kosong. Macam tu. Kita tahu itu tak mungkin dia kosong. This is like, bukan yang company cikai ni. Ni public listed tau. Macam mana total asset kosong? So this is what I usually do lah. And this one is raw data. Raw data. I akan namakan ikut macam tu. And then this is the descriptive analysis. Tapi I tak nak kacau eh. This one I will edit. So. Masya Allah ya Rabb. Koma, tak nampak. Dah check kah apa DBI dia? Belum check kah? Percentage? Besar yang 88%. Aku nak belilah 7-11. 88%. Aku rasa sen lah.
Jangan beli, persen. Jangan beli. Si sorry ah.
Oh eh, saya cari aku nak jual.
Scam.
Eh, hey, okay, this is public
jual,
listed.
Jual not ya. Ya, tempat
bersama.
Aku rasa persen kot.
Persen ya, persen. Percentage.
Bukan persen. Persen nak gila besar.
Persen.
96%.
88.
Bukan selalu bagi semua aset medium.
Cannot be. Aku rasa sen kot. Sen.
Check madam. Check.
Okay. Alright. Check. Check siapa? Aku ada share mana? I just bought Asia. Asia dia bagi tak last year? Asia mana kau? Baik. Asia tak ada? Ya benar. Oh tidak ada. Wah, kosong. Tak bagi dividen. Okey, tak apa.
Jalan si jalan. Nasib terbang. Sudah masuk lah kaunsel ni.
Yalah, siapa yang beri? Oh.
Jangan beli lah dulu lah time tu.
Time tu lah, beli murah.
Murah, saya dah feedback balik.
Serious, if you buy now, it's cheap. If you buy kelaknya dah terbang, terbang lah harga yang tak mampu.
Time kelak dah ada vaccinated kelak confirm naik Asia.
Betul, insyaAllah. Benda lain saya dah. So beli, siapa mau beli, beli. I boleh tolong buka CDS account. Boleh beli dalam, kena tengok. I beli 90 sen, now dah 95 sen, naik sikit lah.
Kini tengah naik Bah Art Asia, okay.
Kamda berapa sen? 30 sen. Eh, buat benar. Kita orang check lah. Gua betul lah check. Tak apa-apa lah. Aku check pula. Sekejap. Siapa?
Naik tu, naik tu. 88. Trusted tak? Betul lah.
Percentage? Besar gila.
Naik tu untuk lah.
Eh, ni. Check lah ni.
Dah di-check dah, dah.
88%.
88%. Even though kita kiranya buy manual pun memangnya dah 88%. If kita ambilnya pull ratio 0.88 sama juga dengan percentage tukar percentage.
This is total dividend lah kira.
Yep.
Bukannya dividend cash, payout ratio.
Cash paid bahagi dengan apa ya?
So, total dividend lah kan? Hah? Ini you kena masa presentation you have to be sure because when I say really 88% or MWA 96%. Gila besar. MWA. Ya aku nak kena check ni. Patin untuk dividend tahun apa tu?
2020
mana. Dah semua keluar ke tahun tu? Ya apa enggak 5.3% enggak? 0.2 je abah. 0.0 dividend. Sampai pun berapa persen ni? Enggak 20 sampai 0.023% je 1. Ni dah.
7-11.
Ah ya, yeah, 7-11.
Oh. Enggaklah.
Bukan percentage ya, besar gila percentage ya. Bankrupt company nah. It's not logic, you know. It's not logic that they
so pay. So macam ni, kita check balik dekat Ibius dekat ya kah? Thompson.
Yes, check so, Thompson.
Break sekali dengan apa? Hanya break sekali dengan formula bah?
Yes, look at the formula and you look at the definition. Look at this. This is 7-Eleven, huh? 7-Eleven. Let me check.
Tapi tak rasa ni pakai DPS lah.
If you use per share lagi teruk. Sikai satu share dia bayar. Munya bayar 88 sen. Kaya raya eh.
Munya per share. Kami tangga stok 32 sen ya.
Memanglah. Tengok ni, dividend per share 2020 7-Eleven 0.02 sen. Mana kat mana?
Pick up.
Dan look at the definition oh, betul ni.
Madam, yang total dividendnya madam?
Data calendar year end value. Yang tu oh. Yang tu diambil you nak? And you have to look at that definition. Based on calendar and value.
Cepat nak share. Ambil share cara kira yang tu ya.
Okay, please share.
Bukan. Share langkup je. Total. Ambil share group je.
Pasha? Now, what class are we having class? My student is asking. BM ka? English ka?
Kita ada kelas sejarah kini tu.
This is class
sejarah.
Research. Apa ni? What am I looking now? Apa di tangga aku? Ni?
Oi, sedah. Kami ada kami share dekat WhatsApp. Ada buka kita WhatsApp. Presentnya kita, kami si present.
Alright,
ini present. Present
kita. Kami si present. Okay. Lambatnya. Cool.
Kasi.
Bottom line.
Yep. Ataupun kita tunggahnya sebagai.
Is this from Thompson?
From Thompson. Nya break definition cuma.
Common dividend cash divided by net income minus preferred share. Alright. So, alright, Fatin, you have to write down this definition. Okay, in chapter 3, and then when people ask you why is it 88%, that is actually the data is given by Thompson, where it is the total common dividend share divided by the net income.
Available to common.
Bukannya per share. Per share aku akan beli enak. Haram je nak.
Nak beli. Si syariah.
Oh, haram.
Tahun berturut-turut si syariah.
Apalah jadi benda haram selalunya mengarik.
Benda haram selalunya banyak bang.
Oh, MW mahal Basil? You beli MW ke Basil? Apa? Oh, dah lah kau sahab dah kutuk. Dah.
Amway.
Bukan Amway, malu. Amway je.
Amway.
Amway.
Amgang.
Okay, this one is not DPR. This is total, DPR ratio. Betul lah. Total dividend over PR. So, 7-11 man, besarnya. Okay.
Apa? Amway.
Amway.
Syariah
kah?
Tapi tahun yang 13, 14, 15 punya si syariah. Yang seterusnya ada syariahnya.
Boleh. Berapa ringgit satu share?
Berapa ringgit siapa letak? Basil kah?
Basil nak beli kah? Sudah nak beli ya. Okay, Fatin. When you explain dividend, you have to explain this is a total common dividend cash lah. Okay, not per share. And the maximum is 99.59. Siapa murid? Almost all tu.
Amway nak minum.
Company tu. Amway ke?
Bukannya. Amway 96.
Bukan.
Amway yang punya dividend per share 64 sen. 65 sen.
Amway.
Amway 65. Sorry. Okay lah. Boleh beli kita. Sapa 99. Kaya Sapa shareholder tu.
Oh
99. 91, 96.
Oriental Holdings.
Shat.
Basil check Oriental Holding. Syariah tak? Tak lain dah aku punya target nak beli saham dah.
Oriental, oh. Oriental si syariah.
Agak-agak.
Tahun. Start dari 2013 nanti 2020 si syariah.
Agak dah. Hotel.
Nya under. Sekejap Nya under barangan pengguna dan perkhidmatan.
Boleh je dah si halal. Memang besar-besar je untuk memang haram.
Oriental, oh. Yes, Oriental si syariah. Start dari 2013 sampai ni tu.
Yolah, ibu lah. So, when you explain, the average dividend paid, total cash dividend paid last year by companies is 17%. Where the largest, the maximum is 99% by Oriental Holding. Macam, that's why, how you explain. Are you guys listening? Faham tak?
Faham tak?
Faham tak? So that means when you explain and when you write in the report, people will know you understand the data. That is the part lecturer self complain. Student tak faham. When they present mean value 17, market cap 139.09.39.04, 199.64.36.16. Si ada perasaan. Ni apa kedai yo? Faham? you kena faham apa yang kau baca tu. Ha, macam itu tu sekarang menilai habis-habis company dia. Ha, dah lah haram benda tu. Now, the median is zero because you banyak kosong, banyak kosong. Minimum pun banyak kosong, betul, sebab banyak yang tak bayar share, that's fine. Tak bayar dividend, that's fine. Okay, what else you need to explain? Now, standard deviation skewness kurtosis is to check whether the data is normal. And ni you dah explain apa normal kah?
Cik dah.
Normal data. Belum. Jack Berra kan? You dah explain Jack Berra nak?
Up until Jack Berra.
Dah, boleh tanya siapa-siapa situ. Sekejapnya faham, ha?
Mungkin faham bagi collect data.
Natalie, Natalie, what does Jack Berra mean? Tut-tut. Natalie? 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 Jadi jawapan lalu.
Yes, madam.
What does, do you know what Jacques Berra is for? Hey, Chelsea left. Hey, Natalie, are you there?
Yes, madam, wait.
You have, look at Jacques Berra kan? What is this for, Jacques Berra?
For normality test.
Okay, what does it mean?
To measure whether the distribution of the test is normally distributed.
Okay, what does that mean? What does that mean? Whether you're normal, it's normal. Sama je nya. What does that mean? Ras, you guys understand what normal mean? Masih faham, Bada?
Si faham.
Si faham. Anak kesalahan. Weh, tak want to.
Si faham.
Si faham. Okay. I nak merit you one situation lah. I've given this situation, I think I talked to you about it. In your class, siapa paling rendah hasilnya? You all dah kenal semua orang kah? Dah kah? Can you write in your chat? Do you want to talk about weight ke height? Guys?
Height.
Height, alright. Can you please write down your height in the chat box? Bukan WhatsApp, chat box. I'm not talking to you, Aisha. I have my own student. Can you write down in your chat box 19M? Okay, Amma. 19M, right? Janganlah kira duduk badan. Okay, 168. Okay, 173. Fadila, 15. Fadila, 15. Aku fikir. Okay, 154. Nazir,
you from now? Amma 198, Nazirul 202 cm.
Tingginya.
Tingginya.
Benar kan? Yang lain tak boleh tengok. Korang tipu eh. Mentang-mentang aku tak pernah tengok korang suka tidak. Nazirul betul. Kau 202 cm ke kau tambah 80 cm tu?
Oh, mending 202.
Is this reliable data or not? This is a problem with primary data. Tak sure betul ke tak? Tak reliable. Nora, you pernah nanggan Nazirul kah?
Pernah, madam.
Memangnya tinggi lah kah?
Tinggi.
Tak lampu nyalan je.
Stop ya, Ru. Sampai hati kalau kah. Aduh, ya Allah. Okay. Dah semua dah bagi tahu? Dah tahu? Datukah, is this your classmate? Sikitnya. Right. Okay, sekarang ni. Let's calculate your average. 198 campur 170. Semua orang kira? Laura 170, Rosilia 168, Chelsea 173, Naziru 202, Fadila 151, Christabella 160, campur, Shahira 154, Pat 153, Basil 178. Okay, yang lain malu. Eh, Ryan. Menandak, Ryan. Nasihatlah. Percaya, terpaksa percaya.
Ryan tu full. Nangnya.
Okay, campurkan, campurkan. And then, divide by the number... The number of you guys here. Oh. Amma, Laura, Rosalia, Chelsea. Kira-kira, divide. Kita pakai all method. Berapa, berapa kita orang? 20 lah? Oh, saya semua boleh. Wait, hide. Hello. So, data collected berapa orang? Observation berapa orang? Observation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11. 11 je. Betul lah ni? Observation 11.
Tak, tinggal.
Benarnya 11 enggak? Rasa ramai orang dalam kelas tu. Ini tujuhnya financial
yang,
data.
Yang
post. Ini utility kah? Utility dengan financial data. 11. You ada 29 orang.
Tidur kali.
Mungkin tidak financial.
Financial.
Not available.
Sebenarnya.
Aduh. Ramainya utilities.
Ataupun tidak sedar report.
Eh, memang aku tolak markah tu.
Listed kali masa.
Ah, Ashikin lah. Ashikin ada. Dia listed. Oh, betul-betul. Nol syariah. Okay, Ashikin. Laura, sebenarnya kau tahu tingginya, Laura.
Best friend ku ya, madam.
You know exact height. 139.99.
Yes, yes. Sebab, yes. Bagi kan 13. Median 162.38.
So, mean berapa?
Mean?
Mean berapa? Mean or average?
Average, average tu. On average. 162.
162. Okay.
Yes. 162.383. Median? Median? Kira ke median buat tu.
Median maksudnya apa? Median, apa arti median? Guys, apa arti median? Cik ingat?
Middle.
Ya, yeah, you have to susunkan nak.
Yes, madam.
Ah, betul. Median berapa? Statistik pun suka lah median. Kita susun mana yang di tengah-tengah. Aduh, median dalam... Kita kena letak dalam Excel lah. 154. Median, median tolong dengan maximum of course lah. Tahu. 04 tu if-nya betul lah. Minimum atau dah? Siapa? Ernie, you kan 60 eh? Bukan tinggi you nak ni ya? 60 cm
ya, ni. Sudah ya. Tinggi kaki kami. Sudah untuk untuk kita show skinness dengan kritisisnya je pun.
Berapa median ni tau?
Cepat.
Untuk mean, I think Patricia terdah. Eh, Fadila. Fadila. Betul? Betul? Median mesti mau pakai Excel tu. Senang.
Oh, saya median. 151.
Bagus Fadilanya. Honest. Sik tidak ada orang. Tambah-tambah 2 cm now.
Oh, kalau wang ya, tinggi sampai pintu.
Nak aku tahu pintu ya. Kan, itulah. So, patutnya
sebab banyak alasan.
Eh, ya Allah Azizul dah paling tinggi 205. Ashikin, kau naik kah? 179? Banyaknya data penipu tu ke?
Sikit minum susu, madam.
Oh, lain pun minum susu juga. Darah tinggi. This is called unreliable data, you know, primary data. That's why we go for secondary data.
Yeah, just questionnaire, madam.
Yeah, questionnaire very, very hard to check. Atika, what are the key in Atika 147? Now we have a different minimum data. Minimum 147. Okay.
Dah lah, stop. Jangan pergi data lagi.
Tak, tu tahu dah. Habis collection data. Cross-sectional.
Tinggi kah tu?
Okay. I need. Eh, kita buat cross-sectional je. Mana ada panel? Tok nak, tok nak ya pandai. Badan pandai naik dalam masa 2 minit tu. Naik 1 cm. Apa dia kira you ni?
Kira masa depan ni.
Okay, now we already got the maximum minimum average. Average is 60. Eh, bukannya 60. Apa pula lah. Sekejap 150 kot. Kira lah berapa average guys. Campur semua divide by the number yang bagi nama data tik. Yang ni Ibu market reviews ni. Excel saja.
Okay, Excel. Okay, salah ya. Kami seorang kira tu. Orang ini kira sekali.
You ya, all. Ya.
Nah, aku ajak kelas tu tujuannya.
Nak aku tahu dalam bendera Palestin.
Okay, darling.
Collect data punya lah lama 2-3 minggu.
Tio, ya, nak anak alu je. Siapa 205 tu, Tik?
Nak aku tahu mana naiknya. Daripada 204. Dah lah, aku main, aku nanggar stok lah. Mamat nak juga.
Meja mau nanya.
Yes.
Bila kita present actual presentation, madam?
Bila? 21st.
Okay, madam.
Oh, tadi dah kakak, Padilla?
Masih, saya belum masuk tadi.
Okay, right.
Ni biasa tertinggal.
Ryan ko. Anaknya Fadila, anaknya?
Tandahnya Medo.
Oh, sabar itu iman kan.
Oh.
Cuba kira lo berapa average? Ya Allah lama lah.
Average 164.
Eh, tinggi juga kelas tu. Pemula eh.
Bertukar Tik, Nazigol dengan Sikim bertukar nyakunya.
Ya Allahu Akbar. Median tak?
Median 169.
Oh, median 169. 169 cm. Masya Allah, maximum 205.
Minimum
147.
Ya.
Sudahlah, ambil. Okay, never mind. Now look at that data, guys. Guys, are you looking at it? Guys.
Yes, madam.
Alright. Now, for that data, let's say we want to run a research on the effect of height and CGPA. Konon. Lebih tinggi CGPA. Hypothesis. Konon. Or lebih rendah, taller persons have lower CGPA. Because literature says that when they sit down and when they stand up, the book is further up. Further down. Hypothesis. Betul. Sebab kepala dengan buku tu jauh kan. Jadi susah nak sampai. Betul. Lagi rendah seseorang tu buku dia dekat. Jadi dia punya ilmu senang menyerap. Konon. That's why we need literature review. Alright. Contoh. So, hypothesis is H1, the shorter lah, person is. Apa kesianas? The higher the CGPA will be or none. This is negative hash one. So kita nak prove shorter person has higher CGPA. So dependent variable will be CGPA lah. And the independent variable will be height. We need more independent variable, tapi maybe weight, et cetera lah. Okay. Are you with me? Are you with me, class?
Yes, madam.
Yeah?
Yes,
madam. I know this is ridiculous. Ramai je akan, but this is not a real example. Korang jangan quote cite my research lepas tu present dekat orang lain. Malu, jangan. No, this is only an example, a cute example, right? So, therefore, kita nak prove. So, we collect data lah. So, your class will be the data with a median of 164. For your information, in correlation and regression later on, we will do that relationship study. And we will use the mean value. I repeat, we will use the mean value to correlate and regress with the other IV. Are you with me? Do you understand? Guys, orang faham sih?
Faham, madam.
CGPA kita akan kira average juga. On average, I nak tanya seorang-seorang CGPA nak ke? Diorang bagi tahu? Boleh percaya ke? Nah, klik. Let's say CGPA average is 3 point lah, konon. Right, average CGPA, median dan semua maximum minimum ada. So, we will use average height, average weight, whatever it is, and we will run the correlation dengan regression nanti dalam e-views with the average CGPA. Are you with me? So, is the average data very important or not? Very, very important. Yang lain faham tak kenapa the very, very, very important tu? Kelas. Faham tak?
Faham.
Faham tak?
Faham, madam.
Kalau average salah, apa jadi pada research kita?
Salah.
Salah dan bias. Bias. Faham si? Sampai hati kau madah. Lebih rendah, makin tinggi CGPA. Salah kita pun. Solution, kita punya recommendation kepada negara, salah kepada semua, kepada bukan negara lagi, lalu berperang orang because of our research, lalu bergaduh-gaduh, ada yang berbunuh sebabkan research kita, sebab bila anak yang tinggi tak dipotong-potongnya badannya, na'udzubillah minzalik. Do you understand how research is so important? In China 20-30 years ago, they made a research on their own and say that if they don't control the birth of children in their country will be overflowed with people. So they make a policy of one child policy. Pernah dengar tak? Yes, China? One child policy. Kalau sesiapa yang ada beranak lebih daripada seorang, either there will be penalty, huge penalty, and they were asked to abort their pregnancy. Kena buang anak mereka. Bila ada yang mengandung lebih daripada seorang, dua orang, tiga orang, anak-anak akan diambil. Mereka akan dibuang kerja. And this is real situation 20-30 years ago. Ramai yang membuang anak. Because if not, the government will macam-macam lah. You know how China is lah. Okay? So that kind of study created that one child policy. So what happened now? Dia punya, itu kuasa Allah Ta'ala. Kuasa Allah, God, dia orang lawan. Sekarang masalah terlalu ramai orang tua. There's no one taking care of them. And the issue is about 1 million anak yang seorang tu, ramai yang anak seorang. Dia orang ada yang ramai meninggal lah. Because anak seorang, ramai meninggal. About 1 million of them now, orang tua-tua, tak ada orang jaga. And government has no money to take care of them. Bila orang tua-tua tak ada orang jaga, dia orang akan, it's a lot of orang tua-tua di China now. Nobody's taking care of them because they have no children, because the government forced them to have only one child. So now they change the policy into three children pula. Last time two children, now three children. So a lot of policies are made because of research which are so untrue and unbiased. Now coming back to our issue here, the average value is so, so important. If your average value is wrong, therefore your data will be wrong. Bukan data wrong, data is not wrong, but your average value to bias. When it's biased, it's called not normal. Are you with me? Itu maksudnya tak normal. Data tak normal because average you skew. Tak normal. Hello? Hello? Fatina, do you understand now? Fatin, do you understand now?
Yes, madam.
Apa maksud data normal tak normal? Data normal tu maksudnya your mean, your median should be the same. Mean di tengah-tengah. Median di tengah-tengah should have the same number. That is the best data. Sebab ia akan menunjukkan the population. In your class now, kita punya mean is 169 centimeter. Betulkah? 164. Betulkah? Apa perasaan Fatin? Apa perasaan Atika? On average, your classmates is your class is 164 average. Is that correct? Do you think that is normal ke tak normal data? Tas? Tas? 164 tinggi ya?
Si normal
ni. Normal data ya? Siapa yang outlier? Nazirul besar. Ah, Nazirul tu terlalu tinggi. Ni apa tinggi lah?
Saya betul betul.
You Ryan, no? Bapa tak Ryan?
You Ryan
dah bilang dengan dia. Oh, Ryan. Tapi, not to say dia orang tu outlier sangat lah. Tapi macam, terlalu jauh lah antara minimum dengan maksimum dengan mean tu. Do you understand the data now? Guys, any question? Hello?
No question, madam.
No question, madam.
So, your data must be 30 and more lah eh. Macam data classmate you sikit sangat. So, right now, what we can say is if we come up with the solution, the shorter the person is, later maybe we say your hypothesis is rejected. It's not true because class you all semua tinggi-tinggi, so therefore your GPA memang rendah-rendah. Macam itulah kononnya nak orang bila. Sebab you all semua tinggi-tinggi. It's not correct. Right, how to check for normality? The idea is kita tengok jap merah. Are you looking at the Excel? Class?
Yes, madam.
Thank you. Jawablah ya. Thank you for answering. What the data is saying, all this, tengok mean dengan median as too far. Standard deviation to 27. Standard deviation means how far is the maximum and the mean tu. Jauh tu. Jauh sangat 27. Sini plus minus 27. Besar sikit lah. But even looking at the data, I think it's not normal. But Jacques Berra confirms it. Okay, take note lah. Apa maksud Jacques Berra? Jacques Berra dia ada dua hypothesis. Ini you dah ngajar less than zero, more than zero kah?
Yang untuk percentage ni.
Belum lah? Okay. You tengok dekat sini lah, probability ya. Probability, kalau probability is smaller than ambil berapa persen, 6% oh, ambil 5%. Dia ada tiga level, 1%, 5% and 10%. I repeat lah, dia ada 1%, 1%, 5% and 10%. Okay. Itu paling banyak lah. Usually for finance, we take up to 10%. Apa maksudnya? Anything below 10% is H null. Below, H alternative. Kalau H null, the value is bigger than 10%. Allah. P value patok. Sekejap. Cik Dayo ko?
Hmm?
Cik Dayo.
Apa ya?
Ya nak, oh, nak kecil, nak besar ya.
Oh.
Mana dia, mana dia? Sun besar. Best ten lah. Eh?
Mo. Terus namo.
Oh, eh, mo. Betul-betul.
Terus dia nak besar? Seriously?
Tak, sampai tekan.
Ay. Beli laptop baru.
Hey. Ya, aku jahit lho, aku jahit lho. Eh, aduh. Minta maaf, minta maaf. Apa benda?
Shopee.
Aku dah kena scam dan nak dah beli lho pakai online. I think they have my number lah.
Dekat Shopee kah, madam?
Ini bukan Shopee. Ini tengah dah ambil je. Orang Japan ke tu.
Nasi bukan Shopee.
And then Big Pay pakai debit card.
Kami nak juga Big Pay ke.
Oh, Big Pay terang. Kurang ibu kah? Dia tak yang mana?
Dia keluar. Selagi kita si beri OTP nya baru.
Oh, aku sikit diperbodohkan. Ajar finance. Oh, percaya gila ni orang. Sorry. Nya si ambil tapi nya call saya. Nya dah minta OTP. Aku macam kena kau minta OTP. Bagilah kami mau kredit duit. Wah. jangan percaya lah.
Siapa?
Oh. Macam ni ada information kita tu yang jadi.
Fresh cakap sama aja. Kes saya. Eh sampai network benda yang lolotnya sama juga. Sampai network si settle.
Kita buat police report semualah. Tapi I think they got it from, yalah macam kita beli Shopee lah apa benda lah. Right. Okay, look at this data. Probability kalau H null untuk Jabera, normal. One H alternate, not normal. Macam mana tahu tu, kena baca balik lah kot, Jabera. You don't have to understand so much as long as you know how what it means. So Jabera, H null, anything the P value here, above 10% is normal. But if the P value is less, it's not normal. Kenapa cerita normal tadi? Tu salah pun saya tu. Salah tu. Cannot be two like that.
Itulah.
Jauh beza tu bah. Tapi sikit kot. Okey lah, ambil tu lah. Betul lah. Alright. So, tengok P value tu. Bigger or smaller than 10%?
Smaller.
Hah?
Kerja terdua.
Tak, so, 1% tau. Okay. Kita tukar pada percentage.
Madam, minta perlu record kah? Record tak lah eh.
Record?
Oh, tak perlu record.
Saya dah minta record pun.
Oh, saya boleh lah. Oh, kita change ya. Then, okay, right.
Okay, now look at the data. This one, siapa tukar ya lah. Tukar macam tak jap.
Dua.
Macam tu lah. 10% ataupun 0.1. Right. Okay, kita tengok. 2.1 is bigger or smaller than 0.1?
Bigger.
So kalau bigger, data normal tak normal? Normal sih. Guys?
Normal.
Alright. If this one is normal, then your DPR, we have checked its percentage and there is a total cash. We know it's correct. And there's a lot of zero, fine, because a lot of companies, they don't pay dividend. But even though the highest and the lowest is quite far, the data still say it's normal because congratulations, your group banyak data observation. When your observation is a lot like this, I repeat, you have a lot of observations, 600 plus is very, very good. So that means your data tu banyak, so dia menyebabkan dia normal lah in certain scans, in this case. Are you with me? Right, let's look at market cap. We have checked it's in billion. So on average, the market cap of the companies in Bursa Malaysia for 2020 is 1.39 billion. Maximum is 71 billion. Company apa tadi? Nama company Supreme?
Oriental. Nak.
Oriental, betul. And minimum is company ni 4.56.
Apa yang tadi minimum?
70
lah. Eh, naklah 70.
Tukar nak best 70.
Nampak, how come? How come? Hey, salah aku cari tu. Apa ya? Oh, negative. It's actually negative. Oh, ayah, ada negatif kah? Ya Rob. Masya Allah, ada company negatif. Hah?
Mau bankrupt apa?
That means nak share price-nya. Adakah share price negative value?
Share price kah market?
Because this is market cap. Market cap is share price times.
Banyak negatif lah. 731.
Banyak negatif. Oh my god. So you find out which company. Apa that?
Dia dah kosong ke macam ni?
9665 oh. Eh, ada lagi yang kecil tu. So that's fine.
This is from a guy. Oh my god.
Everybody can hear you.
Sapura!
Negative! Hi, Shah. Shah, don't dengar tak orang kelakar. Sapura negatif? Biar benar. Basil, apa salah negatif ni?
Maybe nyambut 2019 buat establish malam.
Tapi data kita kan? Ni ada dua company kah tu? Sapura Energy? Entah, tanya one company.
Sama aja.
Ada beza, satu energy.
Satu?
Satu ada Berhad.
Ada Sapura ada juga.
Ya.
Mari kita gelar ramai-ramai. Mari Sapura kita gelar ramai-ramai.
Ha? Sapura ada tiga. Sapura Industrial Berhad, Sapura Energy, Sapura Resources. Yep.
So 571 sampai 573 ya.
Sapura Energy.
So this is legitimate lah. Ha. Tengok ramai yang dah cari untuk you Fatin. People will ask you. So you have to put here lah Sapura Energy. Because you say it just started into 2019. You see, you got this explanation, you write that in your report. And when you present, the maximum company has the highest capital is a rental at 71 billion, while the minimum is Sapura Energy at negative. But it is negative because it probably started in 2019. Wah, bagus kan when you present.
Yeah, it
didn't start 2019. Kami cakap
sudah lama. Untuk dah tahun ke-9nya incorporate.
Ah, habis cerita. Siapa madah tak buat start? Amun panel tahu habis tu.
Mungkin kena dengan saya. Dah kena bohok balik.
Bye-bye Fatin. Tapi if you don't know why, it's okay Fatin. It's okay. You don't have to answer.
Jangan
but if you know, it's fine. Or you can say, this one untuk masters lah. We can say over the 5 years it is shown that it has negative value. It's okay. You don't have to answer for this part so much. You don't have to answer for the company. As long as you can answer, tadi kan ada siapa tanya tadi. Kena ada RM2 tu. Memang ada. Memang ada listed Sapura Energy, Sapura Energy Berhad. Bukan salah. Faham? Patin and your group.
Okay,
madam. Yes, madam.
Okay. So that's fine. That's fine. So now let's look at the normality of the data. we understand that this value is important. Now, mean value is very, 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 the very important. Whether the mean value is normal, whether the data is normal or not. No, median sama. Okay, fine. Look at the p-value. Is it less or bigger than 0.1? Hello? Hello? Is the p-value less or bigger than 0.1?
Yes.
Zero. Hey, 0.0000000. Yes, it's zero. Therefore,
jap, it kami is. Kami nak mencelah. Kami rasa Fatin mau check juga lah untuk Sapura Energy sebabnya ada dua, ordinary share dengan preference share.
Cik boleh lah?
Cik boleh tak?
Betul lah kata Basil tadi, cik boleh duit lagi.
Mau check balik tak? Either yang ordinary ataupun preference.
Nah, you ada data tak? Tiga?
Yang tiga, energy, industrial dengan resources.
Oh, madam, ni ada energy.
Ya, yang betul.
Betul. Yang madam tengok data 571 sampai 573. Ya, betul.
Ya, betul. Untuk yang energy, biasa yang PA ya. APS, sorry.
Dan you double check lah. Takut salah tu.
Biasa kami orang salah tak nama.
Okay. Lalu halak.
Aduh, you make you see? Cemna nak masak makanan tu, Fatin. Mana si halal? Kepala togel lah. Cemna tu. Nampak tak?
Cuba cek balik nyapun RIC ya. Nyapun apa? Kod ya. Kan untuk Sapura tu berapa nyapun kod?
Ni ada yang ke RIC tu.
Cik dah yang ke RIC.
Ya pun I pasang tu juga eh. Sarawak ada company je lah Business Eastern. Sarawak.
Tu
ada situ.
Sarawak ke tu?
Sarawak ada company je lah.
Saya ingat saya sedar madam.
Nyalah ya aku rasa sedar juga Sarawak Oil.
Sarawak lain ada. Banyak kita pun macam contoh Sarawak Pam ada lah. Musawak je.
Ada madam. Kami pun Thompson Datai pun Sarawak juga nyangka. Tapi ni ada namanya.
Apa namanya?
Sarawak Cable kah? Mun Sarawak Cable saya sedar nangka awak pun.
Sekejap saya cari lah.
Sedar. Later on. Sedar means we have question on your data tau. That's how we check. We will look at your descriptive here. Satu tadi we're not sure. And now we identified from your minimum, we have discovered ada dua Sapura Energy cannot be. Nah, you see we can identify from your data here. Negative lagi ya. Sepatutnya market cap set dah negative kok. Because share price set dah negative. Ada negative tapi nya bankrupt. I don't know lah. You ada green packet. Angga green packet Berhad ada duit gitu. Ada satu je sebenarnya.
Berhad ya OS.
Ada banyak tidak tu dah. Guys.
Kita ambil yang OS lah.
Guys.
Musuh ada si MSB. Betul.
Yes, madam.
Yes, madam.
Atau dapat check your data. Atau EG Industries. Bukan utility sih masuk kau. Kejap.
Apa EG?
EG ya banyak yang mana ada negatif tu is incorrect ah.
Okay madam.
Check ah. And then I think also your total asset it cannot be minimum no that this is not available lah. But kalau boleh you put it should be zero. It cannot be zero eh. Total asset cannot be zero. Contoh zero. As in order. If there's no data, you put there NA. Faham sih?
Okay, madam.
If it's no data, you put NA. But you cannot put zero because zero means they don't have any asset at all. Does it? That's why they put tadi kosong. Contoh 449, okay lah, million. Macam tu zero. I don't think Bina Puri. Bina Puri kosong. Ya Allah, nasib baik kusik beli. Tapi ada Bina Puri holding. Oh, ada negatif ya. Ada no. This is preference share thing. Tu je. Box packs, box pack. Ah, banyak data you masalah tu deng. So okay lah, at least you identify now, bukan masa presentation, betul tak? Hmm. Mentau masa presentation, you know what's going to happen?
Yeah, madam.
What's going to happen?
Pada madam Aziz.
No, madam.
You don't know? Mun Dr. Nani apa cerita?
Habis lah, madam kena.
Mun Dr. Nani apa cerita?
Kena
tembak. Masa awal ni?
Korang pelajar, salah. Satu grup telah di...
Gila. Betul, dia pernah interview dalam
Sarawak ni. Telah terjun di Sungai Sarawak bersama-sama.
Bersama dua orang kawannya.
Drama bujang senang. Dia tangkap seekor buaya dekat Sungai Aduh. Sarawak. Na'udzubillah. Dekat rumah saya tu ada buaya? Andai kau, Dr. Rani muda lagi lah.
Sini awak ngoleh informasi ya Amal.
Mana Zahar memang pencen, tapi if you want, we still can call her. Special request. Amal nak Dr. Nohani dengan Puan Nur Zahar.
Google Meet nyanyi boleh juga. Ada masalah.
Eh, Amal nak Puan Nur Zahar dengan Dr. Nohani. Boleh? Your group will be so happy.
No, madam.
Okay. Fun.
Tengok Amal cakap menyeronokkan.
Alhamdulillah.
Saya sokong Amal.
Special request hari ni.
Ah, yes. Okay. Nak bayar lebih tak?
Never mind. We caught your data is wrong here. But if during your presentation, I will ask a lot on the descriptive. Yeah? Because I want to check whether your data is really correct or not. Before you go to correlation regression, before kau masak, yang you potong bawang ya, you dah basuh belum telur ayam? You tahu tak telur ayam kena basuh? You tahu tak? Guys, when you buy the telur ayam, do you wash the telur or not? Tak pun tahu dah, akan makan aja. Because you know where telur ayam comes from, takut ada orang lelaki situ si tahu. Kan dia selalu dengan tai selalu keluar kan?
Dengan tai?
Yes, yeah, ada tai selalu. Walaupun at the farm, they will clean it but it's not as clean as what is. So you need to come home and wash. Apa Ma? Mana kau tahu?
Ayamnya dia memekon.
Alhamdulillah. You tahu tak kalau kita orang perempuan beranak, kita orang kena berak dulu tak? Bukan yang tumpah, yang tumpah bukan berak.
Tahu.
Tahu Atika? Atika, you tahu macam ni tak ada? Ha? Siapa dah kawan kaya awak, Rayano?
Fadila.
Betul Fadila.
Pula ya.
Apa ya, madam?
Siapa dah kawan kaya tak?
Amal.
Amal sibuk anak. For us ladies, when we give birth, the first time I was asked, okay, kita dah berak tak? Ah, dah sakit cintutnya nak berak. Tak berak dulu tanya sebab when you beranak later on, you akan berak sekali. Ini tips untuk isteri-isteri you all nanti dan termasuk ladies kat sini. When you beranak later on, remember what I say, you have to berak macam berak. And yeah, you mesti beranak macam nak berak je. Yang keluar, you tekan naburi. So, sakit dia tak sama lah, Mak. Sakit dia tak sama. Kau pernah sakit, kau pernah daria kan? Berdarah 100. Sakit tak? Masa sebelum I buat anak, I paling takut kena gunting kat bawah tu. I takut kena gunting. But bila times nak beranak, tak ada sakit langsung gunting sebab yang lain tu sakit dah. Kita dah rasa macam, ya Allah sakitnya, ya Allah. Bila dah besar tengok anak dekat profil, letak nama perempuan, letak nama kartun, anime. Sakit jiwa aku. Penat aku beranaknya. Tak orang pun sama.
Anak-anak.
Gambar girlfriend, boyfriend.
Gitu lah.
Anas. Nah, bukan Anas ni. Anas. Apa profil tak Anas? Gambar anime. Anas mana? Anas dah lama tak tak bercakap dalam grup ni. Alright. Right. So, if your data is contaminated, is wrong, raw data you problematic, belum lagi if it's percentage, out. I will not actually look at correlation or regression. In other words, you are a chef. You supposed to cook the food. Bila tak ada food, that means out. Kena buang. Master chef out. Tak ada makan lah. Bila data yang tak betul, bawang tak betul, telur tak basuh, ayam tak halal, habis semua, I will not eat your food. Therefore, tak ada makan. Do you understand how serious your data is? So, good, Fatin and your group members. Siapa lagi? Your group members, Fatin? Share them. Share, Atikah and Afizah? Atikah and?
Fitrah,
good. Your group is safe now. Sebab I've already checked your data. You faham? The other groups, senendak ni oh. Senendak group lain oh.
InsyaAllah boleh. Sudah data Aziz boleh.
Yes, yes. Tanya, tanya, tanya. Okay. Tak boleh, you kena buat macam ni.
Stack. Stack apa? Stack.
You kena stack kan?
Yep. Sebab oh, kena... kamu, awak dah buat dummy kan? Based on sector kan? So stack je lah kalau awak dah buat.
You kena buat kat sini. Stack kan? And then it has to go next to each other.
Betul.
Haa, okay. Contoh lah, you letak syariah kat sini kan? So letak 1, 0, tentulah. 0,
0,
1, 1, 1. Macam ni lah, syariah, non-syariah lah. Syariah is 1, non-syariah is 0 lah. Contohnya kan? Macam ni aja lah. Oh, you kena masuk ke ni. Bila you masak, you nak masak dalam, you pernah masak kat Ma? Bawang tu you masukkan segetup ke you potong dulu? Ayam tu macam mana? Kau baling je dengan bulu-bulu. Semua dia ah, nanti dia lari atas atas periuk. So you have to make sure everything dah dipotong, dah bersih, baru you goreng semua dalam satu kuali. Betul tak? Ya? Yeah? You kena satukan dalam kuali tu. So if you is your kuali, you satukan dalam kuali, that means you kena atur everything dulu. You tak boleh separatekan. Kuali tu tak pandai. Belum bijak lagi.
Ada motosikal lah, Ma. Tak dengar sangat.
Macam ni je lah. Macam ni je, Ma. Oh, sektor.
By industry lah. By industri 1, industri 2, industri 3.
Boleh juga.
Yep.
Ya, ya. 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 Another way is also you can use 1 and 0 lah. Kita pakai macam ni? 1, 2, 3, 4 ke 1 and 0?
1 and 0 by industry.
Okay, macam ni lah. Macam ni tag 1 kan? Macam tu lah. Kan, betul? Bagi consumer, 1. So dummy tag 1 lah. Ini dummy. Ni 1. So mana yang lain tu 0? Yes.
Total.
Yang punya 1. 1. 1. Macam ni 1.
Lebih lah. Lebih di more preferable. More preferable.
Macam ni lah. Faham? This is dummy. Guys?
Yep. Yeah.
Okay, this is to identify whether this company is whether it's consumer or technology. Sama lah. Tapi we do not want any empty spaces lah. Tapi kalau kosong macam ni, make sure it's really kosong. Tapi I rasa bukan kosong lah. Salah. Even your debt. Okay, debt. Kita dah nak habis masa ni. Ini contoh. Kalau ikut value ni tak normal, but I think you double check first, yeah, Fatin. Your data. Okay, and then your total asset, make sure it's also in RM0 juga. Okay, market to book value eh. What is this? RM juga?
RM.
Okay. Eh, saya mungkin tak. Page eh? Market to book value. So, ratio?
Percent.
Percent? 706%? Cannot be. Cannot be.
RM, madam.
RM? Tahu lah, dah baca. Tak apa, fetch tu. Oh, age. Okay, this is in. Yes.
Yes, madam.
Yes. Okay. Then once you find out everything is correct, then you check number two for the normality. You identify mana normal, tak normal. Mana tak normal, okay, I will tell you now. Let's say your market cap ni, semua ni kena lockkan data for edit. Alright. Tengok you all, kalau data tak normal, kita lockkan. This is what we mean by lock data. Because data tak normal, selalunya kita lock. So you have to change it here. DPR dah normal is fine. Untuk market cap equals lock. Ambil data, stop. Eh, ya Rob. Salah. Lock. Yeah. Sorry ya, salah. Yeah. And then you tarik. Nak I ulang ke? I repeat eh?
Yes.
Okay, untuk data tak normal, selalunya anything that involves RM, ringgit Malaysia, very big value, we need to reduce it. So we will lock it. Kita buat equals lock. Buka bracket, pergi sebelah. Sebelah. Enter. Right? So this is total asset for 7-Eleven lock data. What lock data means is they reduce the amount. It doesn't change the amount. It's 200 billion. 2 billion. Total asset 2 billion. They lock into to the power of 10. So sekarang ni double click, dia akan buat semua lock. Ni 6 ni because dia tak ada value, so you just NA lah. Boleh? Press? Kalau data tak normal. Normal biar je. Normal biar. This one is for, selalunya yang besar value macam ni memang tak normal because it's in big value. Kalau market to book ratio, check dulu whether normal tak normal. Macam age pun normal tak normal. Syariah tak payah because memang takkan normalnya, biarkan. Market to book value dengan age, check dulu. So I repeat lah, when you do a descriptive, you look at your mean value. You look at the maximum, minimum, median. And then kan, you tengok betul ke ni percentage. You look back at your raw data. mana yang kosong tu, because macam ni ya, I don't believe total asset should have a zero value, a minimum value. Total asset cannot have zero. Yeah? Debt pun tak boleh zero. Market cap pun tak boleh zero. It's impossible company tak ada hutang. It's either not available ataupun kosong. Dekat sini je, I will ask question to student about 5 to 6 minutes. If they cannot answer me, I said, it's either, I tengok mood lah. Okay, you proceed with correlation regression tapi tolak markah dah. Or, alright, we don't have time, I don't want to see your correlation regression. That's it. Yeah, because from here, I can see your data tu boleh proceed ke tak. And then you check your Jacques Barra, whether it's normal or tak normal. You can tengok H null value dia besar daripada 0.1 or 10%. Dekat sini not data normal, that's fine. Here data will be not normal. So later on in the raw data, you buat another file, you lock it. How to do lock? Just equals lock and then you copy from the raw data tadi. And then you double click and you should get the whole data tu sebagai log. What does it do? Well, the data market cap here 1 billion is 1 billion ringgit. But later on when we do our analysis, it cannot carry that much of figure. In sebab dia akan transfer into beta, yeah? Dia akan dalam bentuk regression analysis, it needs to be in smaller number. So bila kita log, it is transforming into to the power of 10. Sebab tu descriptive tak boleh guna log data. You kena pakai raw data. Ya, yeah? Madam Annie selalu kata pakai raw data because log data is not in actual value. This is already log. You don't show descriptive statistic. Nanti kalau you show what is this, 6 billion, 7 billion, it's wrong.
So madam, lock ya before masak lah.
Yes dear, lock tak dah potong-potong. Sebab you siapkan engkau manuk sikok dalam kuali.
It's on the raw yang before. Descriptive. Okay.
For descriptive, you are describing your data. Describing your data, it must be raw data.
But duplicate data from raw data kan?
Yeah, you simpan kan. This is how I do my data. It's up to you because I see more kacau raw data I bah. Okay, bila I edit, I memang copy paste sebab bila check balik tengok macam tu. Banyak problem tu. So log data is another sheet. Kelak anak ku dengar kelak. It's another sheet.
Mama.
Patch.
So okay. Maksud tu Aziz, patch. Untuk yang nanti discrete analysis, you show yang raw data yang bukan di log.
Betul.
Untuk masa present nanti.
Betul. Log dipotong-potong. Because bila dah dipotong-potong, dah jadi lain dah. This one is before masuk dalam kuali. So kuali-kuali semua ayam dah dipotong, bawang dah dipotong. Okay. Descriptive is looking at the chicken per se. Macam ni lah. Bawangnya buok si. Telur dah basuh belum? Ada ke orang? Ada? Yes? Yes? Any question?
When kita dah lock ya data ya, tapi ya still set normal.
Good question.
Panjang cerita.
Orang yang master level lah, Petrina.
Kena data awak si normal kah?
Oh, sebab dia dah lock pun ya still.
Si normal juga. That means data bapa observation. Berapa observation you? Berapa company?
Kami on bank, madam.
16 ya kak? 16. Observation berapa?
5, 10. 5 bank CB, 5 bank ID.
10 je? Saya cukup makan lah. Yang mesti Pena observation 30 and above.
Pena tak apa?
Oh, panel.
Hey? Panel, madam.
Tapi enggak 10.
Macam ni, oh.
If it's panel 2 tahun, 2 dalam 5, it'll be 10, correct? It's only 2 years data, is it?
5 years, madam.
5 years.
Oh, 5 times 5, okay. 25. Oh,
25.
Kita tambah 1 tahun lagi.
Tajuk you apa?
The performance of IB and conventional bank in
okay, pun, panel tanya dengan you, kena you ambil 2 tahun saja you dapat jawab ke?
5 tahunnya.
5 tahun medium. 5
tahun at least.
Cepat. Cepat, you kena tambah data lagi. Yang mesti lebih.
Sikit gila.
One of the reasons is not normal is because your observation sebenarnya
too small.
Too small, yes, too small.
But yeah, medium pada hari at least 5 years untuk data you reliable. If sikit
tak, 5 tahun. Ni yang 5 tahun, dah 5 tahun tapi 5 bank.
Dia ambil 2 ke 5 tak?
5 bank, 5 tahun, 25.
Macam ya, tambah 1 year lagi lah.
Yalah, tambah lagi setahun.
Maksudnya you ambil start daripada 2015 lah. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Oh. Okay, let's say it's not normal. It's still not normal. For the time being, we can stop at lock lah. Sebab bak kata Madam Annie ada panjang ceritanya. Makanan you si dapat si berapa sedap lah.
Check data balik lah. Ya, entam juga range sebab ada antara range-nya you terlalu besar. Ya, entam data si si apa? Si sini
outlier. Eh, nama outlier. Ada nak ya tak nazirul tak.
Based on you buka based on apa? Skinner dengan ketesis tu boleh tangga apa? If jaraknya terlalu besar, memang probability memang kosong.
The maximum minimum lah terlalu jauh dengan
tangga tangga skinner dengan ketesis ya. Nyapu range dekat ya bah?
Madam.
Yes.
Moon CB kami Allah. Okay, madam. CB yang CB.
What?
All data must be normal. All data must be normal. Yes. All data must be normal, including independent. You understand? So you have to add your data, at least tambah one more data, so it'll be 30. If it's still not normal, then what to do? You still have to proceed, but you declare lah data si normal lah. Yeah.
From early lah, all
mana? Oh, yeah, you have to. But in master's level, you need to make it normal. How? You collect more data, or because correlation regression, you are going to use the mean value. Mean value must be normal. It is supposed to represent the population. If your mean value is wrong, jadi macam kelas tak orang tadi, si normal. Yeah, because of Nazirul ni jadi tinggi gila tak orang. Ni ada tak orang tinggi gila. Nazirul dengan siapa tinggi gila dek? Benar data yang. Nanda Faraya Nazirul mentang-mentang kusik nangga. Understand? But that's a good question. It is still, you lock the data and it's still not normal. Collect more data. In your case, because it's only 25 observation, that is a no-no in statistic. It has to be 30 and above, alright? So, but still, since you still have 30, but if it's still not normal, I suppose it won't be normal, but check again, Madam Ani kata tadi, mungkin data you terlalu jauh sangat beza tu, yeah? And that's it lah, we just have to proceed untuk correlation regression. For today, we are just going to check your descriptive because this is very important. Untuk correlation regression is very, very easy lah. Senang je lah, campak dalam kuali, masak dah. How to interpret data aja yang penting. Okay? So, alright, thank you very much to Group Fatin yes, untuk you share your data.
Mama ada yes, question, Mama ada question.
Kan you kena masukkan data untuk dapatkan descriptive, right?
Okay.
Okay. Yes, you get this, right?
And then?
Raw data.
Dari mean sampai ketesis.
Raw data.
You present untuk yang descriptive analysis, you present daripada mean sampai ketesis tu je. Sebab probability you kan dah kalau dia tak normal, you takkan dah nak present yang 0, 0, 0.
Tak, better present lah, better present. No.
Boleh.
This one, this data lah yang masuk. Raw data. No, you cannot log it first.
Tak boleh log first.
Yes. Yes.
Log hanya selepas deskriptif. Ingat tu je. Yep.
Okay, let's say your total asset is in RM value macam ni kan. Kena lock juga. Walaupun normal. I doubt it will be normal lah. Let's say tiba-tiba calculate kat sini normal kan. Say sini kata tunjuk Syak Berah market cap normal. Selalunya tak normal because the figure is very big. So, when you lock it later, yang ini, you dah lock kan. You just run on descriptive but you don't show it in the report. Maybe in the appendix to check whether the data is not normal. Sebab tu group Patricia tadi kah? Katrina, group siapa tadi?
Kami orang media.
Oh sorry, group Nak Fadila, datanya dah lock tapi masih belum normal kan Fadila?
Oh, still normal, ID.
Because you run your log data ke descriptive? How do you know it's not normal? Fadila?
Madam, masa apa nama tip? Kami orang pun CB yang normal. Kami orang pun IB yang si normal.
Yeah, how do you know it's not normal after lock?
Kami orang pula apa nama probability ya?
After lock. After you lock the data and then you do another descriptive, is it?
After lock.
Okay, then that's it lah tadi. That's the answer lah. Sebab tu Amma, dia tahu dia dah lock, lepas tu dia buat lagi descriptive. Faham tak Amma?
Madam. Madam.
Yes, Najibul.
Even data formula tak pakai lock, kita perlu lock kah?
Which data?
Contoh for RM just now.
Oh, all RM selalunya kena lock lah Najibul. Even though formula in your paper, it does not state right.
Yeah,
usually it will be locked because...
Oh, even though macam adapted paper, dia tak pakai.
Dia tak cakap tu. Dia tak cakap.
Okay, madam.
But that's a good question because in your adapted paper, they will not mention the data is not normal, so kena locked. Sometimes they don't mention it. It's the same thing like kita potong bawang. Kita pecahkan telur. Yes.
Saya nak mencelah sikit. Adakah yang untuk RM tu, RM yang dia punya nombor dia besar ataupun yang kecil kita log walaupun dia normal?
Nazirul, RM dalam bentuk apa? That one is for which?
Is it per share, percent ataupun dia billion-billion?
Yang RM bah?
Nazirul.
Billion.
Billion. Itu kena lock. Kalau sen tak payah kan, Dr. Aziz?
If it's not normal, you kena lock lah.
Kalau dia
kalau
normal, tak payah kan?
Okay, untuk contoh share macam tadi. Tok. H, yes, right? Ataupun, let's say this is ringgit lah.
Okay. Atau,
macam tu, ringgit. RM18, RM19 nak. Exchange yang normal, si payah lah. Faham? No need to lock because if the data is normal. But most of the time, data yang billion-billion ni memang tak normal. Sebab tu people lock.
Okay, madam.
Alright. The idea is later on, we will put all this data in one graph. I repeat, all this data will be put in one graph. Sorry, I still have class. I'm not finished yet. I'll call you back. Is this your number? I'll call you back. Okay. Bye-bye. All right, jap. I repeat, we are going to put all the average value ni, we are going to draw it in a regression line, in one graph. You all faham tak? You all faham tak? Kita nak tengok macam mana sub, in a graph, dia straight line ke negative line. That's what relationship is all about. Whether DPR naik, market cap turun ke, tolak aset naik ke, turun ke bawah, it'll be in a graph. Bukan kita lukis. EVs will do it. EVs will calculate Y equals to, ingat tak dulu? Y equals to constant plus beta X1 plus 2. Ingat tak? Model? Plus, ingat tak? Do you remember that regression model? Y equals
yes,
to C plus B1 plus A1 plus B, is going to be drawn as that in a graph. Kalau graph you ada berbilion, ada 17, ada berjuta, what will happen to the graph, my dear?
Not normal.
I don't know macam kau lukis graph Y dengan X. Yang ni 17, yang billion ni tinggi kat atas. So the graph will not look nice. So everything kena dilockkan untuk mengecikkan. That's why you can see here 6 23 6. Do you see the numbers here? Class, ini contoh satu lah, 7-11. It'll be smaller in a graph. Sebab tu kita lock. Ibarat macam mula nasi himpit. Kita menghimpitkan the number, but we are not changing the number. It's empatkan. Sebiji macam kita potong bawang, potong ayam untuk muat dalam kuali. But the data must be normal. Bersihkan dulu data. Have we answered your question? Class?
Yes.
Okay. Kita tunggu azan jap. Di Sarawak. Alright, class, okay, I repeat, yeah. There are so many things that we can check from the dependent variable here, descriptive analysis. From the raw data, you also have to check NA, kosong, yang kosong ni, yeah, make sure kosong, 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 right? Then when you transfer to eViews, you guys, dah dengar ke? Okay, good. When you transfer to eViews, do your descriptive analysis and you should get this. Termasuk Jabera ni. When you look at your mean, you must make sure, is it percentage? Is it RM? Is it in billion? Remember, it's raw data. Yeah? So, tadi ada check. I tanya, is it percentage ke apa? So, you have to double check. Kalau dalam percentage, that means on average, the companies, how many companies that you collected over what year? On average, their dividend is 17%. Whereby the biggest, the highest is 99% and the lowest is 0. Itu bagi I okay, 0 ni. Because dividend memang kosong. Tapi 99% is very, very, very like almost too good to be true. That's why you kena double check which company. And then you present on average apa, maximum company apa. And you have double check, memang betul they give up 99.59% to cash dividend. Ya Allah besarnya. Tapi haram dia company. Alright, so anyway, and then you check for the normality of the data. I've already discussed with you why the average value to kena normal. Because when your average value is not normal, then your result later on will be biased. How to check for normality? We look at Jacques-Barra. Jacques-Barra ada probability value. You look at hash null, itu normal, where the p-value is bigger than 10% or 0.1. Okay, and then kalau dia tak normal, it is less than 0.1. Ah, macam ni, 0.00000 ni. Ah, ini tak normal. Right? Check dulu mean value, ini billion, check betul, kosong. Right? Total asset cannot be zero. There's something wrong with the data. We've already established this now, data group Fatin ada masalah. So, tapi tak apa, at least we have identified it now. Okay, apa lagi yang masalahnya? Market cap kenapa ada negatif? Total asset cannot be empty like this. Tak boleh zero. Market to book ratio negatif. Okay lah. Kenapa H tak ada value? Dia tak wujud ke? Tak boleh ya? Eh? Maximum company 47 tahun, minimum value dia apa? Tak ada tahun. Tak boleh, tak boleh. Okay, this is not logic. So when I see even one value is not logic, you have to answer because you cannot proceed to the next analysis. Right? Now, let's say all your data is okay. Now, you check for normality tadi. We have identified 1, 2, 3. According to this, it's not normal. Why? Because p-value is less than 0.1. So, what you do is, you copy raw data to another sheet. Okay? And then you change the value to log data. Because market cap is very big, 1 billion. One billion. So we will change, transform. The word is transform the data into log. Macam mana data equals to log, and then copy je yang data ni, and then you tarik je. Okay. Also the same with total asset dengan market to book value because tak normal. Mana data tak normal eh? Mana data tak normal? You just get ready all this data, but check balik lah before you send it back untuk buat descriptive. But when you present the descriptive, only the raw data. However, to check data normal tak normal, in the next process, you just double check je. You don't show it in your presentation. You can put that in the appendix. Right? Okay. Any more question? Itu untuk descriptive dan how we check data normal tak normal before we proceed to correlation dengan regression. Ada soalan ya?
No, madam.
Right. Is that clear? Semua?
So far, yes.
So far, yes. Okay. Terus buat analisis data semua. And siapa tak siap data, collect lah. Ya Allah, lamanya collect.
Hampir siap. Okay.
Remember, 21st presentation, we will have many panels, including siapa nak tadi kan? Tak ada eh?
Buat dah mana?
Mau confirm.
Yes, Fadila.
Kami orang pun data dah after and before lock ya, masih si normal jua. So kami orang design tambah 1 year 2015 lah madam.
Yes. Yes. If possible you tambah lah tahun lagi. Alang-alang collect lah setahun seorang.
So 2014 ke madam?
Tambahlah 10 tahun, 20 tahun, tahun pula tiba. You add more. Because there's three of you, right? Alang-alang collect 3 ajak tahun boleh kan?
So dari tahun 2013 ke medium, mediumnya?
Mendapat sebanyak mungkin, kuantitatif. Until you get it normal, mendapat.
Okay.
Mendapat. That's why alang-alang you collect data, you might as well collect like few years because you just extract it from Thompson, right? Right, Fadila?
Oh, madam.
Just extract it lah. If you want to go 10 years pun okay. You understand?
Untuk IB kami orang pakai ikon.
Then if you can as many data as possible. Observationnya sebanyak mungkin. Then it will reduce the gap. Okay?
Okay, madam.
Yeah, alright. Okay, nothing else? Well, I'll see you on Monday, insyaAllah. Correlation regression. Thank you. Bye-bye. Yes. Okay. Boleh? Tu dah jadi you dah punya. Nak tambah je. Yes. They actually put it in. They don't show it because benda tu lah garam dengan garam Ajinomoto tu tak? Tak payah cakap. Memang ada buat. Memang confirm dia orang buat. Sebab benda tu tak nak, tak malas lah remeh je. Macam tu lah. But for us, kita tunjuklah in your report to show that you know lah. Yeah? That's very good, Amma. Okay, yang lain pun macam macam yang tak perlu lock pun Azrul Madah tadi nak. Then you know you need to lock it. Alright? Okay. Any question just ask lah. Okay, thank you Ernie. Thank you guys. Bye-bye.
Assalamualaikum.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you,
madam.
Thank you, madam.
Okay, madam. Stay safe, madam.
Oh, yes. Thank you, madam. Ya Allah, ya Rabb.
Selamat berbahagia, madam.
Congrats apa?
Thank you, madam.